everyone, how's it going? Today, let's take an in-depth look at the all-new 2013 Lexus GS350 F-Sport. And this is going to be a full, in-depth tour of the GS. We'll start it up, show the engine, get an exhaust clip and go over the performance data, and show you a bunch of the features on the interior as well as exterior. And today, I'm at Hendrick Lexus in Charlotte, North Carolina. And so, without further ado, let's go ahead and start it up, let it run. The vehicle does have a hands-free keyless smart key access system. Basically, if you keep the key fob in your pocket and locate the little touch-sensitive areas on all four of the door handles, you're able to lock and unlock the vehicle. Just tap it, automatically locks it, then after waiting a second, just touch the pad behind the handle and it automatically unlocks it. The exterior color is known as Starfire Pearl with the Cabernet leather interior and black accenting. It does come with a push button ignition. Just put your foot on the brake, hit the button to start. Beautiful. The steering wheel is also wrapped in leather with perforated inserts going across the sides with small side bolster and extensions up top, color contrast stitching running in across the bottom, as well as your unique logo down below and the satin silver accenting. A part of the GS F-Sport package, you have variable gear ratio power assisted steering, very smooth, almost seamless motion, that's also adjustable via various sport modes to increase the driving characteristic and feel for the driver in the road. The vehicle also comes standard with a 6-speed automatic transmission with manual shiftability via down there or by the steering wheel mounted paddle shifters. You also have a standard integrated backup camera with rear guidance lines, and the mirrors will also tilt down once you put it in reverse. It's a very smooth shift housing wrapped in perforated leather and the color contrast stitching with your leather shift boot, satin silver accenting found throughout the interior, as well as the black piano veneer trim gracing the center stack. And we're going to cut on the headlamps. It does have automatic headlamps as well as daytime running lamps, hazards. All four windows are fully automatic. They'll actually slow down a little bit as they get towards the bottom and get towards the top, so it'll just kind of ease and grace on into the spot, creating a nice tight seal. And we'll go ahead and check out the exterior, shall we? The exterior of the vehicle will also beep, letting you know that it's lost detection of the proximity key fob. Welcome to the new GS350. Basically, any preconceived notions that you had about the GS in the past, pretty much toss them out of the window. This vehicle is completely redesigned from the ground up and is basically Lexus's answer to the BMW M-sport package. It features unique front and rear fascias and side skirts, bi-xenon projector headlamps and LED accenting, and a much more angular tone that derives a lot of cues from the LFA supercar. Front and rear parking assist, and as we pan across here, you can see how the definition of the bumper actually flare out in the middle to give it a much more aggressive and menacing tone than any Lexus sedan before it. Bulging hood into the angular grille, and a tapering off lower front lip. The new GS F-Sport isn't all about styling either. The performance has also been upgraded from the standard model, including a specific tuned F-Sport suspension, as well as uniquely tuned exhaust system. Not to mention these unique, dark-finished 19-inch staggered aluminum wheels mounted on Bridgestone Potenza high-performance tires measuring around 235-40s in the front and 265-35s in the rear. Front brakes consist of larger 14-inch discs with four piston fixed calipers, and in the rear, you have a 12.2-inch disc with single piston sliding caliper. All of this basically plays in part into making the new GS a much more confident road vehicle than its predecessor, giving the driver much more pleasure and feel, as well as the satisfaction of a well-balanced handling luxury sedan. Overall length for the new GS is around 190.7 inches with a width of 72.4 inches and a height of 57.3 inches, riding on a 112.2 inch wheelbase and a curb weight of around 3,800 pounds. As we pan across the top of the vehicle, you have your rear antenna for your satellite radio, fully automatic sunroof, broad hood with the new angular definition, fully automatic rain sensing windshield wipers, as well as a new L-style LED integrated turn signal mirror. The vehicle is also now available with an integrated blind spot detection system. In the rear, you have L-shaped tail lamps, a unique design cue to the rear end of the GS with LED integration, your unique rear fascia with modest diffuser-style lower bumper and dark accenting, large dual polished exhaust outlets, as well as a modest lip spoiler. Underneath the deck lid, you have your backup camera, as well as your LED license plate lights, and your rear parking assist. And now we have just a close-up view of the unique rear fascia. Definitely gives that a unique touch in the back. Go ahead and pop the hood. The new Lexus GS350 is powered by an upgraded version of the 3.5-liter dual overhead cam direct-injected V6. With dual variable valve timing and intelligence, it now puts out 306 horsepower at 6,400 RPM and 277 foot-pounds of torque at 4,800 RPM. And with a 17.4-gallon fuel tank running on premium unleaded fuel, it achieves an EPA estimated miles per gallon rating of 19 city, 28 highway. This particular F-Sport is capable of doing 0 to 60 in around 5.8 seconds with a 60 to 0 stopping time with larger upgraded brakes and a short 112 feet. Quarter mile times are around 14.2 seconds at around 99 miles an hour. As far as some suspension data, it is independent front and rear with a double wishbone front setup with high mount upper arms, coil springs, driver adjustable two-mode variable dampers, as well as a stabilizer bar. In the rear, you also have the stabilizer bar, the adjustable dampers, coil springs, but it's also a multi-link setup. The new GS also features electric assist speed proportional variable rack and pinion steering with active rear steer. The interior of the 2013 GS is an absolute masterpiece. As far as the previous generation, it features improvements in comfort, luxury, materials used, as well as styling and features. Starting off here, you'll notice that each of the doors have an integrated aluminum panel that also blends in with the dash, which is a key characteristic for the interior, as well as the satin silver accenting that you saw on the shift knob. Also features full LED accent lighting across the bottom of the doors, your two-tone padded trim going across the doors, very soft with your integrated color contrast stitching, black piano veneer with your power windows, power locks, power mirrors, and three-person memory for the driver's seat. Specific sport leather bucket seating for the F-Sport GS features 16-way power adjustment with all of your standard tilting, sliding, reclining adjustments located down here, two-position lumbar adjustment, one for your upper back and one for your lower lumbar region. Right here you have your side bolster and adjustment. Depending on your body frame, hug you in the vehicle a lot more, as well as a power leg extension up front. Basically to encompass a variety of body types. It's also quite comfortable with a perforated insert in the middle running up across the top, side airbags, as well as adjustable seat belts and headrests. Logoed aluminum door sills, unique sport aluminum pedals, as well as a full power tilting telescoping steering wheel, with an integrated driver knee airbag for increased safety. And let's go ahead and see how she sounds. You can definitely hear that more pronounced tone from the F-Sport's specific tuned exhaust system. Definitely brings out a little bit more flavor of a V8 sound, if you will. Shut her up. Nice and tight door panels. You can see what I mean again with the window kind of slowing down before it hits the top. One of the key interior styling cues of the new GS is the integration of a 12.3-inch high-resolution split-screen mobile media interface with hard drive-based navigation. The new interface is also powered by the next-generation integrated controller in the center. Also found in the RX350 and CT200H hybrid, this actually basically works like a mouse to select your different options on the screen. The newest generation is actually a lot more intuitive than the previous one. You don't have an enter button on the side that you would basically hold like a mouse. So this one is actually integrated to where you don't have a cursor. You just kind of scroll across basically to the general area that you would find your specific interest, and when you find it, go ahead and click down, and that's your enter button. And then you can scroll across to your different options, scroll down, and then across. See if I can get a better view for you. You can kind of see what I mean here. That way, when I'm demonstrating the stuff up there, you can actually know how it works. This particular vehicle comes with the standard Lexus premium sound system, but available is an 835-watt 17-speaker Mark Levinson surround sound unit. The speakers also feature a technology known as Green Edge, which basically more than doubles the output of the speaker, increasing efficiency without actually utilizing excess electricity. Side curtain airbags. Soft headliner. Almost a velour touch. Auto dimming rearview mirror with integrated garage home link. One touch open and close automatic sunroof. All of your interior illumination is also LED with your SOS emergency roadside assistance. As far as the radio setup, like I said, using the mouse to scroll down through your different options. You have all of your preset stations located on the left. With six different menus, your standard radio functions, sound adjustment. Up at the top here, you can see you have your standard satellite radio, HD radio, FM, AM, as well as your different media options, USB, auxiliary, storing your MP3 files on the hard drive, integrated CD changer, as well as hands-free Bluetooth technology. Like I said, this is a dual-wielded screen, so to go to the other screen, just click all the way over, and you can select various options such as your trip information, climate control, and back to your basic radio data. That shows up for every screen that you're pretty much in. So now we're back to the main screen. If we click all the way over and up, it goes to your display settings. You could change the display, the guidance lines, or the different colors for the guidance lines and the backup camera, as well as your color theme for the rest of the system, including your brightness, contrast, and the such. Your destination input for your navigation. So you have your address entry. Quite simple. It's so much easier to use than the previous generation. And your map. Also, it's pretty neat when you highlight everything, it actually shows up little sub icons of the different options. So when you select it, it automatically brings them up. These are the various subscription options as well as things provided through the satellite radio system. When you pair a Bluetooth enabled phone, you also have the ability of utilizing apps and linking apps from your device. Basically, allows you to enable to make dinner reservations, order movie tickets, and pretty much anything you can do with apps these days. Real-time traffic updates through your satellite radio. The vehicle also comes equipped with Lexus Insider as well as Lexus Inform. Lexus Insider provides you updates on current Lexus news as well as tutorials on how to work certain features of the vehicle. Lexus Inform basically is a more of a convenience factor. The navigation system will lock you out. It's a safety feature when you're going down the road, so you're not able to use it. You actually have to pull off the road normally and change it if you had to alter your destination. The Inform system allows you 24-hour navigation assistance and the ability to send destinations to the vehicle from a mobile device or having the operator actually send you the directions. That's also paired with the new SOS Emergency Roadside Assistance. You can activate it there or have it automatically activated in the case of an accident. And down below you have your stocks, sport updates, fuel prices, to try to find the cheapest gas closest to you, as well as real-time weather updates. You have your system set up, the general commands, voice commands, vehicle settings, inputting your maintenance schedules, vehicle customization, all of your personalizable options for the climate settings, light, door lock settings, audio settings, Bluetooth, as well as pairing your phone. This has activation of your various media options such as your Bluetooth, CD, auxiliary, and the like. Climate control. Controlling your fan speed. It is a dual zone automatic climate control system. You can basically control everything from this screen here or by the buttons located down below. Change your different zones, front defrost. The vehicle also has a built-in air filtration system, filtering out pollution, allergens, and the like to give you a more purified experience. And like I said, pretty much all of those other commands are listed down here as well as activation of your rear defrost and heated exterior mirrors. And last but not least, your hands-free Bluetooth telephone screen. Integrated dial pad, storing contacts, voice dialing, along with your hands-free voice command system. With the integrated hard drive and storing your MP3 files, the vehicle also comes with a system known as Grace Note. which basically allows you to use voice commands to search through your music collections, in addition to exploring by artist, album, and genre. It basically will understand mispronunciations, nicknames, the year the song was released. You could also utilize it to search similar styles or create a specific mix for easier, pleasurable listening. As we make our way down the center console, you'll also notice the analog LED illuminated clock, which has a nice conservative touch to the vehicle. Going across, your aluminum accenting, all of your stitched leather going across the dash with the color contrast stitching. The Cabernet leather also extends across here with stitch pattern and a padded stitch center console. It also slides and tilts back. Removable tray, your integrated auxiliary, USB input, as well as power outlet. Integrated cup holders, 3-stage heated as well as ventilated seat for the driver and passenger. And as far as traction and performance settings, you have an integrated snow mode here, as well as a little turn selector for eco mode, normal driving mode, as well as sport and sport plus, and that also basically all works with the engine and the traction control system to either maximize fuel economy and lessen the performance. And you get off to sport and sport plus, which involves spring dampening, suspension tightness, increased throttle response, steering effort, and you can also, unlike previous Lexus vehicles, you can actually turn all of the traction systems basically off in the vehicle to maximize driver performance and pleasure depending on your desire of sport driving. Once you activate sport mode, it'll bring up that little menu indicating that it's active and actually show up in the middle of the speedometer cluster. The speedometer cluster will actually illuminate red, whereas in normal and eco, it illuminates blue. Also, if we go over and highlight Sport Plus, it'll actually indicate the other systems in the vehicle that have been affected. Integrated voice command system.
After the beep, say a shortcut menu command. Say help at any time for additional instructions.
Help.
Help. The shortcut menu contains common voice commands, such as find nearby restaurants. To use voice commands, wait for the beep, then say a command. You can push the talk switch at any time to interrupt the prompts. To change the page, say next or previous page. To see the main voice menu, say main menu. To cancel voice recognition, push and hold the talk switch. After the beep, say a shortcut. Voice recognition has been canceled.
So as you can see, it shows up all the commands on the screen. They're also listed in your owner's manual, and it'll kind of walk you through the process. Your automatic wiper controls, light controls, turning off your traction control, as well as your blind spot monitoring system. You have your hands-free telephone controls, as well as an integrated driver information system in between the speedometer cluster. You also have your radio controls on the other side. Beautifully installed interior and quite well equipped. When you turn the vehicle off, you'll notice that the auto recall function of the seat, for each programmable setting, it'll recall the seat position as well as the lumbar position that the previous driver had. So when you shut it off, the steering wheel will tilt up and the seat will move back to allow easier exit and entry for the driver. Little storage pocket, it's also lined, and you also have your integrated parking brake with the auto hold function. And we'll go ahead and check out the back seat. Back seat room has also been increased a little bit from the previous model GS, thanks to a new seat design. You have the same styling cues traipsing on into the back seat. Back seat hugs you in pretty good. Your LED rear illumination, coat hooks. While you had the unique dash and sporty accent of the F-Sport, the vehicle can also be offered in luxury trim, which offers unique wood ornamentation as well as a variety of unique features. And this basically includes options such as the wooden leather steering wheel offered in a variety of colors, the semi-aniline leather, 18-way power front seat, and as well as memory function for the passenger seat, as well as a unique rear climate and audio control setup, so you can control basically everything from the rear as if you were in the front.
Power outlet for the rear.
Also part of the luxury package, you can opt in for a set of window shades for each of the back doors to go along with the back power sunshade. And a trunk pass through. And we'll check out the rest of the vehicle, shall we? And as far as trunk space, the new GS features around 14.3 cubic feet. It's a nice, broad, wide opening with a medium lift height. Cargo net extends a pretty good ways back. And you also have these little side extensions over here. This one housing your integrated first aid kit. Similar power adjustments on the passenger seat as the driver, except that you have one lumbar position and minus the leg extension and side bolstering adjustment. Large glove box with several tiers, also soft velour lined. Absolutely beautiful redesign. With a plentiful amount of features, fantastic sport and performance additions, as well as styling thanks to the S-Sport package. Definitely sets itself apart from the previous generation and further affirms itself in today's sports sedan market. Well everyone, I hope you enjoyed this in-depth look on the all-new 2013 Lexus GS350. Be sure to stay tuned next time, there's a lot more where that came from. Take care, everybody.